Hello YouTube, it's Ralph again, out for another ride. This time it's a nighttime ride. I ended up having to change my setup. I went back to the Arai helmet because the mount on that Arai helmet is actually on the chin. It's a chin mount with a GoPro. What that means is everything is centered. I don't have to worry about the video coming out slanted, even though the GoPro should correct it. However, when I'm looking at it on the screen, or actually on my phone, because I have the Quick Pro app there, it looks like it's slanted to me. So we're gonna test this night ride to see how it looks, see how the audio picks up. You know, it's kind of dark right here. I'm gonna try to head for areas that are well lit, so that the experience will be a little bit better. I was out and about earlier today trying to catch some footage. Again, working on the setup. Had some audio failures. Go figure. Come to find out, there's a bug related to the adapter that's connected to your GoPro Hero 5 that allows you to connect an external mic. So that's what I'm actually using, is the external mic I have mounted inside my helmet, as opposed to just using the GoPro camera. The GoPro mic, that is, because as you know, the GoPro itself is sitting on the outside of the helmet, and it will absolutely pick up a lot of wind noise. So I wanted to avoid that by actually connecting an external mic to cut down on the wind noise. And of course, I'm going to catch all red lights. Trying to get to that well-lit area. This is a pretty dark street. So hopefully this mount, or the way I have it mounted now, back to the Arai setup, the Arai helmet setup, is working out to be just fine. I was going to make that a left, but I'll continue moving forward. It's going to get a little bit darker here. And I'll go one street over, a little ways up, where I believe the lighting is a little bit better. Getting that nighttime experience. Thursday, October the 14th. That means it's Friday Eve. Come on, Friday. I know we all work and live for Fridays. It's actually supposed to be a great weekend as well. I think a slight chance of rain in this area, but for the most part, the sun is going to be out. It's going to be good weather. Traffic has calmed down since earlier today. I was out, like I said earlier, around the 2 p.m., 2, 3 o'clock time frame, that is. I guess everyone, let's see, either went to work early or decided to just leave work early and come out and enjoy the sunshine today. Make this left here, jump over to one of the main roads there, where I believe the lighting is going to be a little bit better. We shall see. I know if I keep straight ahead, I know it's pretty dark down there. That's one of the routes I take on the regular. It's still in the 70s right now, like 72 degrees. Actually, it says 67 on my dash, so it dropped a few degrees. I guess the farther west I go, the cooler it gets, maybe. If I can go down here and cut through Main Street and pick up some lighting. It's been a while since I've actually done a nighttime ride, capturing video, that is, with the GoPro. I actually do ride at night, but I'm not recording every ride. Now, I believe this has a night mode, but I did not set it. So the next chance I get to pull over, maybe I'll switch it over to night mode. If I recall that it had a night mode, we'll see. It said GoPro Hero 5, I think it has a night mode. Earlier about some accessories that I purchased and had installed on this GS. This is a 2021, a BMW 1250 GS. Not the Adventure model, just the GS. It doesn't have the large tank. It does not have the, it did not come equipped with the crash bar. What I end up doing is I, pur- purchasing some aftermarket head covers, the HP head covers, got them mounted and decided I wanted a little more protection, because eventually I'm going to end up going out and doing a little mild beginner's off-roading. They have trails or roads that are called BDR roads. I think they're equivalent to fire roads, some gravel, some dirt, but they're off the main thoroughfare, and they run up and down the East Coast. I have some friends that I've just met recently and advised that they've been on those roads. And of course, there are no cars there, mainly motorcycles. And off-road vehicles will be on those roads. So I went out and got the Touratech engine guard, the crash bars, that is, and I had them mounted as well. Not that I intend to drop it, but mistakes do happen. So just in case, I have double protection there, hopefully. So I look forward to that, going out and doing a little off-roading. And of course, I am going to make sure I have my camera rolling, audio squared away. I'm trying to stick around and use this Hero 5 Black as long as I can. I just ordered two new batteries for it. One of the batteries is bad, so I'm functioning with one battery now, so I can't swap out. So right now I have an external battery that's connected to the GoPro, and that's keeping it charged and keeping it powered as I ride and take. Get ahead a little bit. Seems like I slow down and the car slows down. Halloween is around the corner, but this looks like Christmas. Okay. A little Christmas, a little Halloween as well. I guess they figured they put the Halloween decorations up, might as well put Christmas decorations up as well. Kill two birds with one stone and just turn the Halloween decorations off come Christmas. Maybe that's the way they're thinking. It all looks good. Getting into the spirit. I tell you, this car must keep slowing down. Waiting for me to catch up. Maybe my headlight is actually helping light the way. Okay, here we go. Into the bright light. Hopefully, well, it's not going to straight up here, I don't believe. So, I'm make this left here, I'm going to actually put this video on pause because it looks like my screen has frozen on my cell phone that I was using to control the video. So I'll be right back in a few. There it is. My 2021 BMW R1250 GS Rallye Edition. Looks like we have success, guys. The audio came out perfect. The video looks great. I kept stating that I'm looking for lighting to get better, but the entire ride, it looks like the lighting was correct. I just wanted to point out what I was talking about earlier in the video. So, when I purchased the vehicle, it did not have these HP aftermarket engine case covers. So I actually replaced them. And then because I'm contemplating going out, or not contemplating, I am gonna go out and do some back road, a little bit off-road riding with this, I picked up the Touratech engine guards as well. So I have double protection here in case of a tip over. Not intending to tip over, but just in case. Better safe than sorry. So that's it. That's gonna wrap up this nighttime ride. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Give me a thumbs up. Tell me what you think. Leave a comment. And hopefully you can join me the next ride. Till next time, this is Ralph. See you later.